Dan, how do you like it here in Montafon and the mountains?
Was that aimed specifically at me?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh. I love it. It's beautiful. Not quite as snowy as we'd anticipated, but it's very nice to be here. It's
fun. And Woody, you came from California. Next show in New Zealand. Coming home, Europe. Is it coming home for you?
Yeah, well, providing I've not been evicted, then yes, it is still home for me. Yeah, we've been racking up the air miles, it seems, this kind of festive period, but it's been fun. Yeah, I've had much worse jobs than this, so yeah, I like travelling around, it's fun.
And would you go up to the mountains for some skiing?
I can't ski or snowboard. My missus can, but I'm kind of paranoid about breaking a leg or something, so I can't play drums with broken legs, it turns out.
That will be bad. Yeah. Will, have you been to Austria before, and what are your associations with Austria, with the country?
We've been here once before, but we just sort of came in and out, so it's nice to actually spend a little bit of time here. I say that, I mean, we spent one day. We didn't mean Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yeah, my associations with Austria are Arnold Schwarzenegger and girls in interesting Austrian clothing.
Yeah.
The traditional.
Yeah, not, sure.
I wasn't talking about anything kinky.
Yeah.
Although on the internet, there's some kinky Austrians.
And I know you like Germany as well. Would you say Austria is pretty
Austria
the same?
Austria is much better than Germany.
Yeah, we love that. Kyle, some fans came from Paris, Milano, Vienna today, which means a 7-hour ride for them. What does it mean for you that they come to see you here for 7 hours?
Well, we traveled like 24 hours, so. It's always great when people care enough to travel 7 hours and stuff like that's insane, and they're not even getting paid, you know. It's weird to go to a different country anyway, and people from that country or from that town come to watch you, and to hear that people come from sort of like places like you said, 7 hours, and like especially in America, they love to travel. They cross the border, it's really nice, and it makes it all worthwhile.
And they waited, I think, about 7 hours in the front row to be in the front row, and they were a little bitch fighting as well. I can tell you. And
define bitch fighting.
Yeah.
Like hair pulling, scratching.
No. A little bit of scratching, I think.
Wow.
You like that?
Well. Back to Will's point on the kinky Austrians. Yeah, yeah, that's cool. I guess I'll look out for the mole in the front row with the black eyes.
Yeah.
Or I guess with the ones with the black eyes will be further back because they lost.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
You know, we'll see.
Okay. Dan, you hurt yourself so often at the concert.
I know.
What was your worst injury?
My worst injury, maybe getting electrocuted, was pretty bad.
The glass through the foot.
Oh, yeah. The time that I jumped on a glass and I cut my foot open, that was pretty bad
but,
as well.
But he had previously smashed the glass, so he kind of set himself up for it. So it was
Not on purpose. I didn't, like, put it there.
Yeah, but today, again, 100% or stay safe? Safety first, or what's the motto for today?
I will be wearing a luminous yellow tabard on stage and a helmet and knee pads, definitely. Yeah, I mean, safety's always first, man. Most bands, if you speak to them just before a gig, they'll be doing their safety checks, making sure they're not going to slip up or anything. I always check the plugs now before I go on stage, just in case.
And I know that you love to play the song The Draw. And why is that, perhaps?
I'm going to hand over to Woody on this one because he's grabbing for the mic.
Because it's fun. Because I get to play drums really loud for like 30 seconds, and I'm simple. Yeah, that's my one little burst of energy. Then I go back to being sedate and quiet at the back.
I think it's because it was like the first really heavy guitar song that we did, and so it's just for the space of that song, we get to pretend that we're in a grungy band.
And we make Kyle play bass.
Yeah, I have to play bass. I mean, there's stickers on the back to not buttons to press, so it's not like playing bass.
But pretend.
It's pretty much like Guitar Hero. It's not even on or plugged in.
Okay.
But it makes me look cool. So.
Will you play today as well?
Yes.
That's a resounding yes.
What, don't you know the set list? Because we're looking.
There's a lot of songs. You know, you can't always.
So much space up here.
There's not a lot of space up here. We will play it.
Okay, and then what can the fans expect today? Are you looking forward now to rock the show?
Yeah, we're really excited. I hope we can rock it. They can look forward to it. Well, we'll be playing a whole bunch of stuff. We've got some new songs that we're going to play. In fact, it's the first time we'll ever play The Driver in Europe.
Okay.
So there we go. And I guess this is like our last European show of the year, and probably for quite a long time. So we just want to have a fun gig tonight and hope that the crowd are not too cold and are up for it, and they're not too like scratched up and punched in the face from all the bitch fighting.
Yeah, okay.
So we just want to have a good time. We hope people will have a good time with us. That was very cheesy, and I apologise.
I've stopped. About you?
Stop talking.
You asked the question, so yes, carry on.
But there's dead air. There's dead time. I should fill it, right?
Just dance if you want.
Dance.
You can.
Okay. Thank you very much, guys, and enjoy the show.